Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you've been here before, then welcome again. And if you're new, then welcome to the curly unicorn world where we talk about everything curliness and hair and skin and makeup and life things, I guess. So today's episode will be, today's video is a little different because I'm doing like a vlog style. But basically, I'm sorting out all my used hair points, and I'm just gonna go through the empty ones, and I'm just gonna tell you about them and if they help my hair and recommend them and stuff like that. So yeah, if you haven't already subscribed, just click the little subscribe button and the little notification button for more for a video every Tuesday. This video is gonna come out today, which is a Friday, but I normally post on Tuesdays, but this is a special one. So so just click subscribe, please. Keep it a bell. Hello. Thanks for being here. So yeah, so click subscribe if you haven't already, and yeah, so let's get into this, shall we? So you're sitting here, you can see me, okay, and you're sitting right here in the world. But can just anyone just see me? Click on those new videos. I want to believe. What? Too much longer. Okay, so let's sort this stuff out. First of all, this is empty. This is on Jackie's Curl Boss Coconut Curling Cream. It's sulfate free, paraben free, no mineral oil, and no petrolatum. Okay. This one was the first fork gel that I used, because before I was just using DIY gel, so this one was the first one and it helped a lot. It smells like coconut. The ingredients, it has glycerin, so if you can use it in summer but maybe not winter. Yeah, it worked really well. It kept hold my curls and it kept my curls nice. And yeah, so if you want to get this, I recommend this. Right now, I'm actually, instead of buying this one, I got the tub on the curl, on Jackie's Flaxseed Recipe Don't Shrink. So this is more, it makes your curls look longer rather than this one shrinks your curls up. So you have look more curly, more defined. And this one's more like it elongates it, so like it makes it longer. I don't mind. Alright, so as I was saying before I got interrupted, yeah, this one makes your curls more longer, and this one shrinks them up more. So if you want more defined curls, I would go with this gel, but I'm quite liking this one. And they both smell really nice, so like they both, do you want to sniff them? They both have really nice smells, so yeah. Those are the gels that I'm using. Well, this is the one I'm using right now, and this is the one I have to throw away, because it's been sitting there for a while. Yeah, so let's go on to the conditioners. This one was one of the first conditioners that I actually got before I started this method. This is the Alternate Blends conditioner, the color limit with argan oil and cranberry, and this is actually really great. I always forget about it, but it actually makes my hair really curly and moisturized, so it's like a secret weapon. I would use this. It has no parabens and no silicone, so it's all good. And yeah, so if you want to try this, it's really good. It smells really nice. It makes my hair really curly, and I always forget about it. I'm like, and then I use it and I'm like, whoa, what made my hair so curly? I'm like, it's this stuff. It's this stuff. So yeah, I would try this. All the other links are in my description for all these brands, so you can go check them out. But yeah, so I've had this one, it's kind of been sitting there, it's finished now, so that's, I'm gonna throw this away now. Let me get some more of that. Yeah, this is just an empty container. This was in there, because I stole some of my sister's, and I was like, you know what, she there, she gonna know. if you're watching this, I kind of stole the conditioner. it's finished. I finished. So yeah, this was in it. There's still a little bit left, but yeah, it's basically finished. Because I was like, you know, I made my hair so curly, so I want to go take my sister's wool, and I kind of used it. But yeah, so it's really, this is really good, really good. I need to clean this. So yeah, that's the one that I really like using. I don't have any more of it because I've been using. I'll talk about the conditioners I'm using now, just now. But yeah, this is this one. This is Anoche Mother's Naturals, and this is Tahitian Gardenia Flower and Mango Butter. This is a curlifying conditioner, so it is meant for defining your curls, and it really did. I used to deep conditioner with this, and then after I deep conditioned, my curls would be like defined. It's finished now, but I mixed it the rest with some water, and I use it as like a little bit of a leave-in conditioner. So yeah, it's kind of like a conditioning water type thing, but I think I need to stop throwing it away because the water is gonna get old. And yeah, so this one's a really good one. I would buy it and use it again, so it's recommended. I really liked it, and it smelled amazing. It was like the consistency was more runny, like liquidy, but yeah, it smelled amazing. I used it a lot, which is why I finished it so fast. But yeah, I used this one a lot, and it was really great. Okay, so this one was actually, this is one of the first conditioners, this is actually the original bottle, and one of the first conditioners I used 4 months ago when I started my curly hair journey. So this is the Anoche Mother's Naturals linseed chai blend and French plum seed oil. This is the volume boost conditioner, and this one worked really well. I used this one, and this one, I've had this one for 4 months. This is a royal honey and Kahilirin Desert Melon. This is the repair and protect conditioner. These two together work really well. So all of these together, just get all the scale and not your mother's, okay? They all work really well, and they're all just really great products, and they just make my hair really nice, smell nice, soft, just everything. So yeah, I fill this one with water too, but I think it's been there for like a while. So yeah, I have to get rid of this now and get some more. This one still has a little bit left, so yay! Yeah, I really like this one. It's really nice. It smells nice too. Okay, so those are conditioners that are finished. These ones are the conditioners that are finished, and I have to like move them away. I just kept them here to look at them. That's fine. Now these are the conditioners that I am using. This one is almost finished. Look, it's almost finished. Why? This is the Body Shop, and I actually have a lot of the products now, and I really like their products. This is the Banana True to Nourishing Conditioner. I actually made a video where I tried this on, so it was like a few weeks back. You can go check it out. But not only does it smell really nice, it made my hair really curly, moisturized, soft, all that thing. So I recommend the Body Shop. I also have this, which is the I'll get into that just now. This is one, I just got this one, and oh my gosh, it smells amazing. The consistency is really interesting. It's like creamy. And this is the conditioner, Clearly Glossing Conditioner, the Strawberry, it's Body Shop, and it's for dull hair. It's working really well. There's no silicones. Is a harsh alcohol, which is supposed to dry out your hair, but it is way down in the list of ingredients, so there isn't much of it. So it hasn't dried out my hair yet, but I've only used it once, so we'll see. I'll continue using this and see what happens. But I really like the smell of it, and I'm liking it so far. It does have fragrance, is pretty high up in the ingredients list, so if you're more of a natural, like you just want natural ingredients, then I would go with these ones, the Anoche Mother's. They have a lot of natural ingredients. So I'm using that conditioner, this conditioner right now, and let me just get this one. This one is the Ginger, it's Body Shop again. This is a Ginger Scalp Care Conditioner for dry scalp and weak hair. This one smells really great, and I've used it a few times, and it works really great. So yeah, all the Body Shop products I would recommend. They work really nice. They have mostly natural product, natural ingredients, and there's no silicones, so that's a plus. So those are the conditioners I'm using right now. Yeah, so let's move on to shampoos. Okay, so this is, I didn't originally buy this one. It was actually my sister's, and it didn't work for her hair, so she gave it to me. I've done a review on this. If you want to go back and check my review on this, then you can, explain more. But it's not for my hair type. It's more for wavy hair. It is sulfate-free. It does have mineral oil, though. It works really well, though. It smells nice. It moisturizes your hair, and yeah, it does work really well. It's not for my hair type, but it does work really well. So if you want to try out this, go try it out. So that's the shampoo. It has it. It's almost finished. I used it on my dog. Yeah, I actually washed my dog with it, and he smelled amazing. And yeah, it was just yeah. So he kind of finished it. This shampoo I've used once. The reason why is I bought this, but when I looked at the ingredients, it doesn't have ingredients back here, but when I looked at the ingredients online, what did I find? It was sulfate. So this does have sulfate. I've used it once. It didn't dry my hair or make my hair bad. There's no silicones, but it does have sulfate, so I use this only when I really want to cleanse my scalp, which is like every few months. I'd probably use this just to like give it a proper cleanse and then go back to not using sulfates. But yeah, so it does have sulfates, so I was kind of disappointed. I was like, oh, I really wanted it not to have sulfates, so I'd use it. So yeah, that one is one that I'll use once in the blue moon. So those are my conditioners, my gels, and my shampoos. So I forgot about these. Okay, this one is one I literally just got the other day, and this is the Curlella on Jackie's again. I really like their products. Defining Curl Custard. So this is a Curl Custard. It smells amazing. There's no silicones, sulfate-free, paraben-free, no mineral oil, and all that stuff. So this one's really good, and it defines my curls, actually. Like, I've used it right now, and you can see it's defined. So yeah, I'm really liking this, and I'll be doing a review on this probably in a while. This is Body Shop again. This is the Banana Truly Nourishing Hair Mask. It's basically deep conditioner, and I finished it because my hair is long, so I need a lot. Okay, this smells really nice. When I deep conditioned my hair with it, my hair was so nice and soft and just very nice. So if you want to try this, I recommend it. It's finished now, but I'm just gonna keep the containers. Don't fall. Okay, this was kind of the first cream, because this was like, I bought this a few months ago, and this was the first cream I bought, and I was really excited about it because it has avocado and shea butter, and it detangles and smooths and adds shine and all that stuff. And then when I was in the shop, I didn't look at the ingredients properly. Because when I came home and I looked at the ingredients, it has mineral oil and it has dimethicone. Okay, the dimethicone is way at the bottom of the ingredient list, but still, it has dimethicone. I've used it once or twice, but I'm going to do a test on it and a proper review on it later on, just to see if it does weigh my hair down, if it does build up. But yeah, it does have dimethicone, so eh. So it's in my kind of graveyard, you know, it's sitting there. Yeah. Okay. This is a face wash that I got, and it's pretty much full, and I haven't used it because it has sodium lauryl sulfate, which is actually bad for your skin. It makes you have more acne, so it's kind of in my graveyard too. So it's kind of just in there in my graveyard. I have a graveyard of products, because what? And to think, I only started off with 3 products, and now I have like this whole shelf here. How cute. Okay, now on to oils. Alright, oils, hair needs oil, and this was the first oil I got. This is the Olive Oil Miracle Anti-Breakage Formula. Maximum strengthening growth oil helps stop breakage but ends in dryness. This is actually really nice. This one was really nice. I used it like for 2 months and it worked and it was just amazing and I loved it. So if you want to try this out, this is African Pride and it was really nice. It worked. It helped my hair grow and yeah. So this is an oil I recommend. I'm kind of sad that it's finished. Like, but right now, the oil that I am using is also an olive oil. It's olive oil formula with Jamaican black castor oil. This is olive oil growth therapy for healthy hair and scalp. This one is interesting because it's more like it looks like a gel and then it turns into an oil. And it's been helping my hair grow and I quite like it. So if you also want to try this one, it's also, they're all in my link in the description below if you want to look up the products. So yeah, those are the oils for my hair that I use. This one is an oil, avocado oil. I actually didn't use this for my hair. I used this to shave. Yeah, it actually, oil works well with shaving or conditioner. And right now I use oil, or I just use a scrub and then I shave. But yeah, I'm gonna have to throw this away because it's kind of been sitting there. Yeah, this is just an empty bottle. It's the baking powder. I actually have baking powder. I keep baking powder for DIY face stuff and all that. But yeah, those are my products that I use. So now I've cleaned it up and it looks a little better. This needs to just go. Yeah, so those are my products. And these are the ones I'm throwing away. Those are the ones I'm throwing away, honestly. And yeah. I forgot to say, this is an oil that I'm using now. This is still a male oil. I haven't used it in a while, but it actually works really well, so I should probably use it soon. Yeah. So those are my products. This is my face wash that I'm using now, if anyone was wondering, which doesn't have sulfates in it, which has been helping a lot. And then I use a lot of honey and turmeric on my face. So I'll do an updated face skin thing soon. And then what I also use on my hair is this. And this is my DIY hairspray that I use, and it's also been helping with my hair growth. So you should go check that out. Actually, there's a video on my curly hair Instagram, which is also linked down below if you want to go follow that. So yeah, those are all my products that I've sorted out now. So it's more neat. And yeah. So that's my products, and that's the ones I'm throwing away. And I highly recommend them all. They all work for me, so if you try them out. Yeah, comment down below what your favorite products are. Maybe I can try them out on that. So yeah, if you like this kind of vlog style video, give it a thumbs up, and yeah, I'll see you next week with a new video. I'll be doing a new video on how to make your own lip balm soon, and some updated ones, and all that stuff. So be prepared, be in tune. And I'm going to be doing a special video that is something you should watch, because it's good. So yeah, this is just a surprise video. I don't really post on Fridays, but I was in the mood to make a video and I needed to clean out my stuff, so I thought, why not? So yeah, hit the subscribe button and I'll see you very soon. Have a nice week and a nice day and a nice night. Bye guys. I just wasted 10 seconds of life. Also, I have a curly unicorn podcast, which is down in the link below. you should go listen to that because I posted a new episode every Tuesday and it's pretty sweet. Yeah, also go follow my Instagrams for more curly hair things. There's a curly hair Instagram just for curly hair things and makeup things, so make sure you go check that out for me. Have a nice day. Bye!